CPM or critical path method, how CPM disrespects people. In this quick video, I am going to explain to you how the critical path method disrespects people on a fundamental level. And once I'm done with that, I'm going to link you to a longer video where we can dig into this topic even more. So if you're into that, stay with us on this amazingly quick video. When we talk about CPM, we all know that the structure puts us into a time by deliverable format, which I don't like, with a string of activities, and those activities are logic tied, and the CPM algorithm will identify what's called a critical path after its forward and backward pass. The critical path is the longest path where if any activity is delayed, it delays the entire project. Okay, and let me tell you why I don't like this and why it disrespects people. First and foremost, in order to create this database, not the whole team, meaning there's multiple people on the team, but just one person, which ends up being the super or the scheduler, do this by themselves in a silo, and they create the plan themselves. And so not only does that disrespect the rest of the team because they don't have good visibility, they can't see it, they really can't be a part of the planning and do a fresh eyes with it, but also when you're doing CPM, you end up disrespecting yourself. Because after about 500 plus activities, you can't even see what's in there. And so now we have taken human beings out of the equation, relied entirely on the computer to solve the problems, and now we have bad logic, bad sequences, and a bad database. So CPM fundamentally disrespects people from the fact that it's not a collaborative tool. Another way that CPM disrespects people is that when you have that, well, this is called a schedule, and that is just given to trade partners, and it's forced on them, and they're controlled and put in a box and said and told, hey, you have liquidated damages, you have to follow this, this is our plan, let me give it to you. Not only does CPM only have a 15 to 40% hit rate, not only is it not a collaborative plan, not only is it not a realistic plan, not only is it not a plan that you can't see, but it's being shoved down the throats of trade partners. And it's used to abuse trade partners and contractors, it's used for liquidated damages, it's used for cure notices, it's used for all kinds of abuse on a construction site, and it's a worthless tool, so it was never real in the first place. Let me tell you the other thing that really makes me upset is that in the CPM system, when you do the forward and the backward pass, and I haven't found a better term for this, so I'll just keep saying it, you basically scrunch everything together. You don't have trade flow, you don't have crew flow, even though people say that you can, and you can't. I've never seen a CPM schedule actually have it. You have large batched areas, you have trade stacking, trade burdening, you have all the bad things, right? And what happens is, if you look at this from a work in progress and a time chart, meaning at the intersection of this, there is a capacity line for your trade partners. Let's say it's listed there. CPM will say, oh yeah, okay, well let's do this, trade partners, you have to do this. And here's the point, everybody thinks that CPM is gonna let you finish your project sooner. No, it won't. That is not how it works. As soon as you increase the requested work in progress above capacity, your project is actually going to finish out here. All the while, when you're pushing, rushing, panicking, with additional labor, working overtime, with lots of materials in people's way, and you're just throwing money at the problem. So you're hurting the trade partner's finances. You're hurting people with the overtime. You're putting things in people's way with the materials. You're wasting money from the project team and disrespecting the owner. On and on, you're disrespecting people with your rush and push and panic. I hate this thing that happens with CPM. What you really should do on a construction project to say, hey, let's keep a flow and keep the requested work in progress in line with the capacity of resources and finish on time. And so these are the reasons that CPM really disrespects people, in addition to the fact that you're rushing people, in addition to the fact that you are adding excess labor, which hurts finances, in addition to working overtime, which hurts people, in addition to spending too much money, isn't good for anybody, especially the trade partners and the owner, actually for everybody, and because it brings out too many materials, which get damaged and creates stops and restarts and also puts things in people's way and creates an unsafe situation. CPM disrespects people on a fundamental level. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I'm gonna put this into a little blog post and a visual and then link you to the longer video if you wanna check it out. I hope to see you there. On we go.